In this week's video, we're going to talk about a very subtle, kind of low-key, but really impressive feature in dbt known as analysis. It's a default folder, comes out of the box when you initiate dbt, but I feel like, at least in my experience, it often gets overlooked. So we're going to take a look at when you would use this and how to actually go about doing that. So what is the analysis folder and why would you use it at all? So if you look here at a default project here, we can see there's the analysis folder here, analyses, I guess is how you pronounce that. And in our dbt project, we have the paths for it here. That's by default. And really what it is you're writing ad hoc SQL queries for a variety of purposes, which we'll touch on. But the benefit really is that you can use dbt and Jinja to compile all these things. So, you know, all of the ref functions, the looping, the iterating, the lists, kind of flattening, all this stuff that you can do with dbt and Jinja, you can just do it for an ad hoc query. So what are some examples of when you would use this? One, like I said, the ad hoc SQL analysis, or maybe some testing that you want to do and you just want to spin up a query. Another example would be for maybe for a reporting tool. You don't want to actually deploy a model. You just want to have a query compiled. Then you could use this. When we're talking about analysis queries, we're not deploying anything. Nothing gets materialized. It's, you can almost think of it like an ephemeral in a sense. It's just compiling code that you can copy, paste, do whatever you want with. Another example might be maybe you don't have permissions to deploy something, but you want to see the output of something of within dbt itself. But again, you can't deploy it. You could create an analysis query, compile it, have the query to at least run and get a data set from it. And as I keep saying, overall, the main point here is you can use the functionality of dbt to compile code, compile a query, and then use it elsewhere. It's not something that's going to deploy anything. When you do a dbt run, nothing's going to happen. And when you do dbt test, nothing's going to happen. So with that out of the way, let's now take a look at how you would actually do this and a quick example of what this looks like. All right, so I'm back in my project here and we'll go under analysis. And like I said, it's just compiling code. It's just a SQL query. So let's create a new file. We'll call this random script. SQL. And within here, we can write whatever we want. It's the equivalent of writing a model, really, in terms of code or maybe a test. So test is another example here, you know, where you could have, you can use the Jinja functionality. So let's just take this. Let's say we wanted to take this query, but instead of using it as a test in this example, we really wanted to see just a data set. Let's just change it a little bit. We'll say we want this. We just want these three columns from this here. And again, I just want to point out the main difference here, as opposed to just writing SQL, because you could just write this, is you want to take advantage of the compilation power of dbt and of Jinja. So let's go ahead and save this. And now the way to build this would be to do a dbt compile. And because we have this in the analysis folder, it will find that for us. So we can see there's one here, one analysis. And as it compiles, it's going to put that in a separate directory for us. So let's go to target. It'll be under target down here, compiled. And now we have obviously our models and tests, but we also have analyses. And here's our random script. And we can see it converted it to what we wanted. And we can copy and paste this and do whatever we want. This is an incredibly simple example, but just imagine, you know, you can use macros in here. If you had something that you had worked on as a group, you could add that in. You know, anything that we've done here, similar in dbt, like for example, with the variables or macros, like I mentioned, any of this stuff could be used as a script. So let's say we wanted to do this here, save this, and now compile it again, just to show that the macro is going to work. We have, again, a source reference here, and this would give you an output that you could take and do whatever you wanted with this. Let's see if it updated for us. And here we can see it did. Gave us everything. It substituted the macros and we're all set. And if we take a quick peek at the documentation, here's another example. But as it mentions here, a lot of times, obviously dbt is built for models, but sometimes we just, you know, it doesn't quite fit that mold and you want to have something a little bit on the side that you can use. That's where analysis comes into play. So a couple of things just to consider when you're thinking about using analysis is, first, is this something you want to materialize? If it is, you should probably create it as a model and not analysis, because you want it to be persisted in your warehouse for other people to use and not have to copy, paste, and rerun it. So if you can deploy it and it makes sense, you know, go ahead and build it as a model instead. The other thing to consider is this a test? Are you trying to test something? If you're testing something, it'll make more sense and be more valuable to add it as a bespoke test or bespoke. Okay, I don't know how to pronounce these things sometimes, but by building it that way, you can take advantage of the DBT test functionality, which opens up a lot of other doors for automation and different ways you can use it. So again, if it's a test, think about adding that query as a test as opposed to analysis, but again, kind of a case-by-case scenario. It's another tool in your DBT toolbox. Think of it that way. So that's it for this video. Thanks as always for watching, and let me know what you think about this new setup. I don't know. We'll see how it goes. And as always, see you at the next one.